Summer is over. We're back.
Yeah, everybody got here on time with smiling faces. They look like they're ready.
All the teachers, all the staff, we're so excited. The kids are running into school and they're so motivated to be here and to learn. So it's been already a very positive start for our children.
All of the kids were so excited to be here this morning. Lots of smiles, very few tears. So we know it's going to be the best year ever.
It's been a rip-roaring day. Had a lot of great folks outside this morning. A lot of our teachers were out greeting kids as they got off the buses. And it's been a pretty darn smooth morning for the first day of school.
Started off with transportation, dropping all the students off on time. We got to classes, got our kids' schedule straightened out. About 10 o'clock, every kid had their schedule in their hand, and we've been just ironing out the small minor details since then. Other than that, we're running really smoothly. First days without a glitch.
So far, so good. I've gotten to meet a lot of students, start to build some relationships with them. Just kind of learning the schedule still, seeing how students interact and move in the cafeteria. It's much different in the high school setting than it is in a middle school setting where I was at last year. So there is a little bit of a learning curve, but the students are taking it in stride. I'm taking it in stride, and we're having a great first day.
The thing I'm most excited about is watching the class of 2015 enter the final leg of their journey.
I'm excited to work with this grade level. Been at the high school for many years and seeing the great kids that have been coming up to us, and I want to see where they come from. And this gives me that opportunity to work with those kids, get them ready as well.
If I had to count them, I'd say probably six or seven all together, new faces. Mm-hmm. So we're excited to have some new faces with us.
The conference room has been converted to the preschool conference and itinerant. So we've got a nice size conference table in there, and we're going to be able to meet the needs of IEP meetings, ETR meetings, etc., in a comfortable atmosphere.
I'm excited about getting to know the families. I met a bunch of people last night at our meet and greet, and it was so good to get to know them and just see their enthusiasm, and excited to see what kids at Chippewa are all about.
It's going to be a great year. We're excited to work with the teachers and the children and put a lot of great programs out there.
Most importantly, just providing a great education for the students that we have every year here.
This summer, we had about 95 teachers attend a professional development seminar, and it was about the professional learning communities and how that can be used to help with standards in the classroom. So, kind of briefly, can you give us a sense of what that was about?
Our instruction will be better because it'll be geared to what my students need as individuals, not as a whole group. You know, we're not shooting down the middle and hoping that everybody gets it. Instead of grading children, scaling them and looking at what do they get, what don't they get, and if they're not getting it, how can we help them? And I think we're all on board with that. Well, that's kind of nice that we're all kind of on the same page.
So we spent a lot of time meeting individually with teachers and going over standards and how they should teach. We spend a lot of time talking about assessments and the way that we can assess students in traditional and non-traditional ways. So I got a great job in which I can help a lot of people make a big difference in the district.
And we are in the newly renovated adaptive kitchen for students with disabilities, correct?
Yes. We are very fortunate and very excited to have this kitchen. One of the things that we work on is trying to create math and science and language arts and social studies opportunities that are real life. Mm-hmm. And you can do that. You can do science experiments with the kitchen, and they get to see processes, but also it helps them in their life outside of the classroom, as well as their, you know, going into their future after they leave Brecksville-Broadview. So
Heather Piasecki, who is our PSL president, took this on a couple years ago, just redid the whole courtyard, and now she really works hard to maintain it. She will get students throughout the year, especially third grade students, to help maybe at one of their recess periods. She does a fabulous job of maintaining it. It's a great place for kids to come out and read and do quiet activities.
It actually looks just as nice as it did last year. The flowers have bloomed very nicely, and we thank the PSO and Mrs. Piasecki and all the people who do this type of work for us, because without them, we just couldn't do business the way we do.